the rest of people will come back sooner. And okay, good afternoon, good morning, good evening, everybody, to online participants. We will not delay anymore. Now I'd like to introduce Professor Andrei Kasilov, who is now a managing director of the Regional Network for Educational and Training in Nuclear Technology, StarNet organization. Andrei is professor of the National Research Nuclear University, MIFI, from Russian Federation, and he has long, more than 50 years experience in nuclear field, obtained his PhD in nuclear engineering, and he also was awarded the by the American Nuclear Society Training Experience Award in 2001. He was working in the IAEA for the several years and published more than 150 scientific publications in his professional life. And Andrei, please share your presentation now and please give your lecture to us. Sorry for the delay.
Okay, hello everybody. I welcome participants who are in the Kastler House, and I'm very pleased that some participants also online, and greeting to everybody. Let me first of all to share my screen. My presentation, I hope you can see it.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, I will go to the presentation mode. Is it better? Okay.
Yeah, yeah, perfect, perfect. Please go ahead.
Okay. And then the title of my lecture is Building Competencies in the Strategic Planning for Sustainable Nuclear Energy Development. You will see that my lecture and subject of my lecture is a little bit different from some other lectures. Mainly lectures will talk about a different aspect of technology, and I will discuss a little bit different domain. I will discuss the people who are dealing with this technology and the approach, how we can build competencies of these people in order for them to manage all this innovation, technology applications, and make it available for mankind. Then let's go to my next slide. And I think this some kind of rationale for model curriculum on strategic planning for sustainable nuclear energy development. The history of this approach is quite simple. First of all, I think I should mention that International Atomic Energy is always supporting the sustainable nuclear education and training in member states, recognizing that the future generations, young people especially, they should have additional sufficient knowledge and skill to do the nuclear business in different aspects of nuclear technology, applications, and whatever. One of the important aspects is in all these things, this evaluation of long-term sustainability of nuclear energy systems. And innovation technologies, they play a significant role in this process. International Atomic Energy has a project, INPRO, and inside of this project, there are a lot of achievements received during last maybe 10, 15 years in this area. And by the initiative of the INPRO, the people who working there together, they decided to develop something like a curriculum, standard curriculum or model curriculum, which give the universities around the world some kind of support and booster to develop competencies in this subject area. And I was one of the member of the team. The compositional team was a number of the nuclear experts, plus teachers, educators from different universities from Europe, Canada, United States, and together we suggested something that I will present to you right now. Then I think, first of all, as I already mentioned, but maybe a few words more, the need for competencies in strategic planning for sustainable nuclear energy development. If we will look for long term, so definitely these competencies should be in place in order to run all these activities. And that this competence include as should include as understanding of general approaches, the philosophy. They also should include the some specific knowledge of the specific tools and instruments which are available for analysis and modeling the sustainable nuclear energy education, nuclear energy systems. Before going to some details, let me discuss what we will have in mind when we are talking about competency or plural competencies. It's important because there are a lot of different definitions and different approaches that the people calling competencies. In my particular presentation, I will have in mind the following things. That first of all, it's in some kind of statement that defines a particular area of knowledge, skill, attitude, or behavioral that is required to perform a particular role or task to a certain standard. The competence we consider as ability to put skills, knowledge, and attitude in the practice in order to perform a task or role in the effective and efficient manner to an established standard. Simply speaking, the competence is knowledge plus skills plus attitude. These three components, they are quite important for the nuclear engineers and nuclear specialists. They should be knowledgeable, they should possess proper skill and attitude to do the job which assigned for them to do. Sometimes people talking about the competency framework. Competency framework, it's a competency is a structure within which knowledge, skill, and attitude are organized. We, for example, can talk about competency framework for technology innovation. We can talk about competence framework for assessment of nuclear energy system, and so on and so on. This is a general understanding what is knowledge, and in order to give you, I can say, more thoughts, hints to remember. This is a simply competency graphic display which presented the some kind of the mixture, the competences, skill, knowledge, and attitude. And if they are possessed, then we have a competent specialist, and this competent specialist is able to perform tasks or activities. And of course, when we're talking about the knowledge, this is information, and mainly sitting in cognitive domain. When we're talking about skill, it's ability to do something. This is a physical domain. When we're talking about attitude, this is a psychology domain. It's a manner, this disposition, feeling, and so on and so on. But all of them quite important, because if we will talk about the practical world, when we're talking about knowledge, it's a huge field of the different information, different data, what you possessed at the universities on your professional life. Then you're talking about the skill, its ability. And when you're talking about attitude, this is a lot of important thing, for example, safety culture in nuclear field. It's sitting here. It's your attitude, how to performing all these activities. The another important thing before we'll go deeply, it's how to measure competence. Because competence could be obtained on different levels. Sometimes it could be initial competence or initial information. It could be ability to use this knowledge in some limited space, limited and or you can do something very sophisticated. There are different approaches in this. If somebody met it before, there is a Bloom's taxonomy, which is giving six level of the obtaining the knowledge. But in practical field, we suggest that three levels will be quite enough. This is a knowledge, the first level. This is a collect and compare. Then demonstration, to demonstrate that you have this knowledge, and implementation, how you will implement this knowledge. It's also important because people can be quite maybe informed, but without ability to do something. And this is a so-called knowledge ladder. It's presented here, that knowledge, it's know a specific level of knowledge, demonstration to demonstrate application of the knowledge, and implementation to implement the knowledge. This is quite important because you will have some group activities and you will be asked to do something. And the last general slide, it's giving you some kind of the general, again, approach, how the competence can be obtained in order in the end to have a competent worker. And member states, in fact, needs for specialists for strategic planning for sustainable nuclear sustainable nuclear energy system. And then you see that, in fact, in the real world, the competent worker is a product of different activities. The important thing is that university, where the people obtaining the basic knowledge through education, they mostly it's they obtaining knowledge, partly skill, of course, and professional training, where the people mainly receiving the skills and attitude when they're doing this, and all this mixture giving the, some kind of the professionalism, and we in the end getting the competent worker. The task of the course, which I will present, giving you ability at university level to start preparing the specialist in this area. In fact, that the main idea to give our students at master level some kind of the feeling of the holistic approach in the application of innovative nuclear technologies and their relationship with the energy system in general and the nuclear energy system in particular. This is the main task of the course which I am going to present. Of course, one of the main idea, what the purpose of the course. Generally, I already told about this, but nevertheless, if we will talk specifically about the purpose, of course, the curriculum, the model curriculum, and associated educational models, which are already developed, they support capacity building and national human resource development in the nuclear energy sector. Especially this important for newcomer countries, where this knowledge is really needed, and there is some gaps here in the competent people who can do this kind of the activities. Specific objectives, as I mentioned, to provide knowledge and practical skills in planning and modeling of scenarios on nuclear energy system evolution and using INPRO methodology in Tatela. Then the specific objectives also to familiarize the students with INPRO concept of nuclear energy system stability in different areas. And these areas are indicated here because INPRO considering the superposition or different areas studying economics, infrastructure, waste management, environment, configuration, reactor, innovations, and so on and so on. And the goal also for this course to develop understanding of sustainability issues in the planet system and ability to perform nuclear energy system analysis assessment in selected area using the already developed intra-methodology criteria. It's not so simple sometimes. Then, as I mentioned in general, but more specifically, target audience. What we developed, they mostly for students, master students in nuclear science, nuclear technology, and nuclear engineering. But some training models, which already developed, educational models, they can be useful for students who are studying international relations, political science, management. Also, some educational models can be useful for students or for specialists who continue their professional development. It means for retraining and for obtaining additional knowledge. It's also quite useful. Prerequisite of the course, they are, if we are talking about master level courses, definitely the bachelor course, bachelor degree in nuclear science or engineering is required. And sometimes the specific requirements will be needed for some educational models. And these specific requirements were developed for each educational model, which also, I think, will be presented in a couple of slides. Then, when we are talking about the competency area, this is the approach where, in which particular field, we'd like to increase or develop the competences for our students. It's a group one, energy planning and strategies for sustainable development. It's a very general approach. It's not about only nuclear. It's energy planning and strategy for sustainable development in general, considering the different sources of energy. Group two, competence area, it's a planning for nuclear energy sustainability. When the decision is taken that we will go in the particular countries in the with the nuclear options, then the competencies will be needed here according to the group two. Group three is extremely important, and they are linked to the subject of the present workshop, current workshop, innovations in nuclear energy sector in meeting sustainable energy development challenges. It means that how the innovations in nuclear sectors can help, can assist, and can be used in meeting sustainable energy development challenges. We are doing these innovations not for innovation themselves, we are doing it for our society, we are doing it for energy development. Group number four and five, they are more specific. This is a nuclear energy system modeling and analysis and methodology for assessing sustainability of nuclear energy systems, the intra methodology. They are giving, if the first three competence groups, they are providing the, some kind of the general competences, very high level and very deep, then group number 4 and 5, giving the participants, students, very specific competencies and ability to make their analysis, modeling, and so on and so on. Then, based on all these discussions, we are coming to the course composition presented here on the slide. And more specifically, it looks like this. That according to the competences areas, which I already discussed, then the core models will address model one, energy planning and strategy for stable development. Then model two, planning for nuclear energy. Again, I stress nuclear energy. And model three, innovations in nuclear energy sector. And this model will be for this workshop is our special attention, and you will understand it later on when I will present the activities, group activities number two. Model four, it's INTRO methodology, introduction to the INTRO methodology. Model number five, method and tools for planning sustainable energy development. You see nuclear, what is not here. It's a general tools which are developed by International Atomic Energy. And model six, method and tools for modeling and analysis specifically nuclear energy systems. And also a lot of instruments, approaches, they are already developed and they're placed and they're available and they can be used. And our students should have introduction to these instruments, how to obtain these instruments, how to work with the students and the instruments, and how to apply the students for their research probably. And that's why the last model, model seven, this is a research project model, where research projects on planning and assessment of energy and nuclear energy systems would be considered. Of course, this research model will provide the highest level of the competence, and then using the these tools in their research project or maybe thesis or another thing that people will define some kind of task and make a solution for the organization or countries on national level or whatever. This is a general description of the tools, and in order to give you more feeling, I consider not all but some of the educational models. For example, I go to educational models, I think all models have a standard structure, which are presented here. Short description of the model, learning objectives, prerequisite, learning outcomes, outline of the model topics, suggested teaching delivery methods and student performance assessment and bibliography. I hope that you understand the old wording here. If not, ask me, what does it mean? Learning objectives, well, short description, I think it's quite clear. Learning objectives, normally general statement about the some objectives that we'd like to establish before we start this course, this model. Prerequisite, it's a condition for students in order to be assigned for this model. Sometimes it's quite simple, like a bachelor degree in physics, mathematics. Sometimes for the specific models, and I will show you some examples, the specific competences needed, maybe even some courses, pre-model courses to be taken. Learning outcomes, it's extremely important statements. Practically, learning outcomes, it's a statement characterizing the level of the competence which students should reach after completion of the model. And I will show what does it mean. Outline of the model topics, its description was in this slide, and our recommendation. Please keep your microphone muted during the presentation. When you will ask questions, then of course switch off on your microphone and ask. Suggested teaching delivery, it's our recommendations, how to organize the training, education process and whatever. Bibliography, I think it's quite clear. What does it mean? Then, first example, it's a Model 1 energy planning and strategies for sustainable development. Main topics, they are presented here. I will not read all of them. We running in the short time, but nevertheless, from the observation of these topics, you see that it's a general approach for understanding what does it mean, the energy planning and strategy for sustainable development. What kind of the topics should be considered in order to, consider different challenges in this area. This is in global energy supply demand, energy resources, economics, social aspect, climate change, energy security, and other things like this. This giving the very holistic approach to the students about the energy, supply in our planet in different countries, they should understand that there are different sources, and these sources would be used in different regions and different countries differently. If you continue differently, this is the objectives, learning objectives for this model, establish understanding of technical, economic, environmental, social, geopolitical consideration, the development of sustainable energy strategy for a country or region, and familiarize students with the evaluation of potential role of various energy resources and technologies in meeting future energy needs for sustainable development. It's especially important competency when the newcomer countries trying to decide, is nuclear for us is a good option or not? You should consider the general picture and then make your selection that yes, nuclear is our choice because we consider all these things and now we are going and decided to go there in nuclear area. And this is a statements about learning outcomes from completion of the course. You can see that the students should be able to do something very important thing, demonstrate familiarity with methods and tools, explain the different aspects, explain some energy resources and demonstrate understanding of the economics, methodology, and so on and so on. This is giving the, I can say, general energy culture to the specialists in nuclear field. And we think that it's quite important, especially for the future nuclear specialist, to understand the role of the different sources and based on this, to understand the role of the nuclear. Then, if you're going to the model two, that's things are very similar, maybe by topics, by title, but all this model about nuclear energy stability, role of nuclear power in combating climate change, public acceptance of nuclear, introduction of a sustainable nuclear energy system, nuclear power reactors and fuel cycle, economics, risk and benefits, and so on and so on. And of course, in this model, the people first time will receive the overview of the INPRA methodology, agency methodology for analyzing and assessing the stability of nuclear energy system. But it will be general introduction of application of nuclear energy in national or regional energy system. This quite important educational model. Then, of course, we have learning objectives. They are very specific. They based on the topics and based on our task. I will not read all of them, but I think they are quite important. Again, understanding of all these factors, which have a few influence on the nuclear energy development, international obligations, norms, standards, safety, maybe standards, application of nuclear technology, and so on and so on. How it fit to the UN concept, how it's related to the green energy and concept, and so on and so on. If you are going to the learning prerequisites, it's a different basic knowledge in mathematics, physics, and so on and so on. The bachelor degree in nuclear engineering, it's adventure. It's very demanding and for understanding of this model. And one of the requirements is successful completion of the core model one. If on the core model one, will give you the general picture about the different sources, the model two will give you guidance and knowledge about the application of the nuclear. And on my next slide, you will see the expected learning outcomes that which people should possess in Model 2. And some kind of the measures which I do not only to have a knowledge, but also demonstrate this knowledge and also apply this knowledge in some kind of extent. But for example, number three, perform exercise on dynamic nuclear energy system modeling using NES simulator and economic analysis of NPP level with NES tool. Maybe it's not so clear what does it mean NES tool, but explanation is that NES tool, it is specific agency developed instrument which provide ability to make some economic analysis, like other simulators, they are available and so on and so on. Then I will not again read everything, it's just for illustration. We can, it's a continuation of the expected learning outcomes for model two, list my national responsibilities, describe briefly IMPRO methodology, summarize potential benefit that people should be able, students should be able to summarize these benefits, to have a justification, and explain that they should demonstrate this knowledge in some area. How to do it? There are some kind of insight recommendations which will be published and available next year. I am jumping from other models to model six. I am intentionally jumped through the model three, which are related to innovation. We will put a special attention to this model later on. But this model five, six, method and tools for modeling and analysis of nuclear energy systems should give you feeling about specific competencies which should be developed within this course. Look here, the, this is a NES mass flow and economic analysis. NES simulators, simple models of nuclear energy. Then NES road mapping. It's an instrument which available road maps IT, ET. Multi-criteria decision making for adjustment or aggregation. And NASA economic support tools, and so on and so on. It means that if you go to deeply the inside of the learning objectives, this is a very specific, like explain the basis of mass flow analysis, multi-criteria decision making for adjustment aggregation, familiarize the students with IMPRO approach, describe the IMPRO approach for different instruments like NES road mapping and another for analysis for different aspects. There are in the document, which will be, as I mentioned, published, I hope, next year, you will find, who will be interested, the list of all this instrument with explanation and with some description what they are for and how they can be obtained. Then prerequisite, very specific for model six, and then knowledge is quite deep needed for model six. It's a software and no skill needed, some knowledge in the particular nuclear field needed, and completion of the model, for example, the model two, and model one is also should be completed. And advantage of this model five method and tools for planning is also here. And if you will see on this slide, next one, oops, sorry. Ah, it's okay. Then expected learning outcomes for this model is very specific that, for example, illustrate familiarity with presenting nuclear development plans with road maps ET. It means that students should demonstrate that this instrument they understand, they learn, and they can go to the specific case study using this instrument. And others like this, kind ET, this is some kind of comparative evaluation using this and other this outcomes. We can continue later on this in more detail. But I'd like that you will recognize some evaluation if the first models are they getting general knowledge and general understanding, developing, formulating some kind of general competences, then the model 5, 6, and 7, they trying to develop in the students very specific competences, which will be applicable in their working place. One of the final slide before I go into the case study, the course implementation. If you look carefully then on the structure of the models, you can recognize the suggested educational models can provide basis for a different master degree courses. This could be general course, it could be very specific course, and it depends on university which will implement this. Of course, very ambitious task to implement the course in the full extent using the whole models. But nevertheless, some people who, for example, dealing with international relations or management, they probably can take the course 1, 2, 3 and some more specific knowledge, which in another models could be provided to the nuclear specialists, nuclear engineers, who will go to the national organization and to provide the analysis and applying the innovative technologies in the some deeper extent. International Atomic Energy is going to support this curriculum implementation in different dimensions, in different way. First of all, it's agency tools for energy analysis and planning. As I told, they are available and they can be obtained through the agency and by requesting, university can request it and get it. They are free, but sometimes they are quite sophisticated and it's not enough just to obtain them. There is a need sometimes to get a special training how to use this, how to use these tools. That's why the second bullet, it's training of the agency methods, models, and software tools in the subject field. Because sometimes they are in economics, sometimes they are in the analysis, evaluation, whatever. That's why agency is going to provide training and teaching material for educational organization for developing, using, customizing, or adopting teaching material employing the model curriculum. That people and university who developing this educational course, they also can use this curriculum, this material, and obtain some kind of help from International Atomic Energy in some personalization or customization of this curriculum. And we hope that pilot implementation of these courses in different universities also will be with the help of the subject matter specialists from International Atomic Energy or from the industry who can provide their experience. That's why we are planning organizing fellowships at the agency for practical study of subjects associated with model curriculum, some scientific visit, fellowships, and so on. Course is going to use cyber learning platform for nuclear education and training It's so-called CLP for NET. It's platform available for member states, and they could be used for promoting the training material and other things. And of course, plenty of the agency publications which are available in the agency for free downloading. If I go to next my slide, this demonstration, the document which our group is prepared. Practically, it's ready for publishing. There are now some kind of editorial challenges here, but I hope the document model curriculum on strategic planning for sustainable nuclear energy development will be published next year. And here, that some structure, I hope you can read. This is generally what I told, but in more detail, the general part about the course, task, competences, and extremely important annex one, description of the educational models. This, if you can see from, it's a main part of the really document, which is giving the precise description of each educational model and recommendation how to teach and how to obtain the knowledge according to this. This is my part of the lecture. Then if you at this point have some questions, I will be happy to answer, because I will not switch off this presentation. Maybe you can ask about specific slides. And then after the questions, we'll go to the next file, next presentation, and we'll talk more specifically about innovation technologies and some group activities. Go ahead, please, if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer.
First of all, thank you, Professor Kasilov, for the nice presentation. Interesting topic directly related to the topics of this workshop, how to transfer the knowledge and other things. Now, if you have a question from the audience here.
Because you will need to perform the group activities, maybe some people would like to clarify what does it mean competence, what does it mean learning objectives, learning outcomes, or how to demonstrate it, and whatever. Any questions, please.
Moment, we have questions here. Also from online audience, please.
Yes, I. Yes.
So I noticed a tool called Message, M-E-S-A-G-E.
Yeah,
What's its function, and is there any alternative tools for energy planning? I mean, is it for the whole process, the planning, and how to?
Probably it's a special, very special question. And if you'd like to have overview of the different instruments and what they are doing, I just afraid that I can give you not a really precise information. What I suggest that you will go to the agency website, International Atomic Energy Infra, it's through Google or whatever, and you will be directed to the nice description of all instruments. That's probably will be better than I will answer by through my memory. I really afraid to give you not maybe not precise information. Then I suggest you, and of course in the document which you prepared, but later on I can give the link if you wish in the chat, then you can read explanation of message and other instruments. It's also possible.
That would be great.
Okay. Yeah, I will give the link later.
Also, Alexander Bychkov from INPRO tomorrow, arriving tomorrow, so he could probably answer. Any other questions?
No, no, I give the, it's the, on the side, there is explanation of this model. There is a brochure about the model. I also can send to Vladimir the PDF version of the brochure where the all tools are explained and described. Probably it will be interesting for the all participants. It's probably the better.
I we give can you also upload to the next to your presentation.
Exactly,
by the way,
exactly. And you can upload as a training material.
Mm-hmm. And by the way, Andrei, please also submit your presentation in PowerPoint.
Yes, it's for sure.
Yeah, so we'll put it on the website.
Okay, then I will. Nevertheless, I'm ready to answer, but I will go to the next presentation, group activities.
Okay, please go ahead.
Okay. Then we'll go to...
Excuse me, we have two questions from... We have two questions please. From yeah. Online audience.
I have a question. Sorry, Vadishtu.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. I'm Mansoor from India.
Yes.
I have an... It's a great presentation, sir. I also know that you providing the syllabus and study material for all the countries. Are you able to listen, Misha?
Yeah, that you're talking about material for everybody, but I will send it to the scientific secretary, to our director, and they will upload this material on the ICP site, that it will be available for all participants which are present and which are distant. No problem.
No, so my question is, sir, is the material related to only strategical kind of things, or is the technical also? We will get a technical kind of things of material of reactor physics or material.
What do you mean technical?
Technical means means how to design a reactor and kind of all these things related to. Already it's available, books are available there, but it's kind of material which is very useful, like a Monte Carlo simulation related material, or there are so many simulations are going on all
the time. No, you see, when
I'm
talking...
Is also
no, when I'm talking about simulations here, of course, I have in mind the technology simulator for different power reactors type or something like this. When we use the term simulation here, we are using the special simulator, which giving the possibility to simulate the nuclear energy systems, and how and when we consider nuclear energy, different nuclear energy system, we when you are building the nuclear energy system, you are considering different options. You are using the different technologies. You are different approaches to the fuel cycle. You are different reactor types, and so on and so on. All these things they could be simulated, and you can see how these different technologies, different approaches can give what influence, impact on your system, which you are going to establish. And for this, to have a simulation of all this system is extremely important, because it's not only some general things, the very different the statement that fuel cycle, which you can, how you can use technology, that what kind of reactor and so on and so on. In this respect, these things are very technical, because you need to know all this technology. You need to obtain this technology data, and you need to have knowledge in all this field. That's why when I was talking about model number 6, I mentioned that there are a lot of very specific knowledge needed to be in place before you're going to this model. Because if not, you simply will not understand what it's about. That's first of all. That's why it's master degree, and even in master degree, you need to be some knowledgeable person in software application and technology application, because if you don't understand the difference between different fuel cycle phases or different nuclear technologies, reactor type, you probably will be not able to perform this task. You need to obtain this knowledge from your previous study. Or even sometimes in our university, when the people coming to the master level on from bachelor, which are not really general engineering and not nuclear, we ask them to take maybe sometimes 1 year course in nuclear technology before we will give them access to the course on the nuclear engineering in the master level.
So this is not simulation of the reactor or nuclear power plant.
No. It's not simulation of the reactor.
Of the nuclear energy system.
It's simulation the whole system. Nuclear energy system simulation.
Okay, understand. Okay.
Simulation of the reactor, it's another business. We can talk about this. And that's I was involved in different simulation technology. But it's another task. Full scale. Replica, different types, and whatever. This is another domain, which is also extremely important. But it's different from what I am talking today.
Okay, Professor Kasilov also prepared the group exercise for the group activity, and now he will mm-hmm. be delivered. Please be,
Yeah. What I suggest full attention. To do.
Please yeah. go ahead.
This is group activity two. And I call this activity innovations in nuclear energy sector in meeting sustainable energy development challenges. If again, it's some kind of maybe a reminder, I described five groups, competence area, and for group activity, I made a choice. I select the group number three, innovations in nuclear energy sector in meeting sustainable energy development challenges. Again, if you remember, it was just maybe 15 minutes ago, we were talking about these models and task for the group activities or will be framework of this model three, innovations in nuclear energy sector. What is suggested to do for the group activity? Task for the group activity two. For model two, innovations in nuclear energy sector and meeting sustainable energy development, the people is requested to develop learning objectives. What they think should be the general goal of their training or education in this model. Then map of model topics. What should be inside of this topic? What the people from their experience or their imagination will put in this model, what it should be model about, what from their point of view should be prerequisites for this model, what kind of knowledge people should possess before going to this model, and of course to develop some kind of learning outcomes, how they measure the knowledge which will be obtained from this model, how the people in our group who are sitting here can suggest how to measure. I explain the approach as something like this. Look, we have a model three. It's on the left side. Then people during the group activities will develop different topics. Main topic one, topic two, topic three, and whatever. Whatever, it's up to you. Then, of course, these main topics could be also developed, further developed on different subtopics. When you will do these things, and when you will teach these things, you should imagine that people should demonstrate something after the teaching, after the education process. And this will come to the learning outcomes. Learning outcomes, what people, students, should demonstrate after the training. It's maybe considered differently. You can consider this from the left side to the right. Then you are developing topics, and you are developing subtopics, and then you will imagine what, just suggest what people should demonstrate after this. It's a more or less traditional educational approach, which was in place for during many times. Now the people do it a little bit differently. If we have a model and we establish learning objectives, then we need to develop, first of all, learning outcomes. What we'd like that people will demonstrate, possess after the this model will be, I can say, developed and delivered to the students. Then, if you will go to the outcomes, if you will discuss collectively that after this model, students should know this, should demonstrate this, or do whatever, perform this, then your task will be to develop and suggest subtopics and main topics, which will be sufficient to create these outcomes. Do you understand my point? Because learning outcomes, it's product after educational processes. If you will establish the requirements for this topic in the from the beginning, then you should develop the educational process sufficient to create these outcomes in your students. I prepared already some general hint. This is the learning objectives of the model. This is the main objectives: to describe the needs for technological institutional innovations and improvement in nuclear energy systems with the goal to achieve sustainable development and deployment. This is general goal this model should obtain, but it's very general. More specifically, it's up to you, up to the group. And I will be very interested to see your approach, how to develop this course, this model, what topics should be addressed, and what kind of the knowledge and skill students should be demonstrated after completion of this model. This is my task. Is it understandable?
I'm afraid not very well, very well. So we need more details, Andrei. First of all, may I ask you, could I give your email address to the participants?
Yeah, sure. No, that the key point, this is this one, that we have, look on this picture, that we have title of the model. Mm-hmm. It's clear, innovations in nuclear energy sectors. In meeting sustainable energy development challenges. What does it mean? It means that we are not considering this just innovations, because the whole workshop about innovation, about some type of reactors, about approaches and whatever. But in this particular model, we are looking how these innovations, support nuclear energy sector in order to provide sustainability in nuclear energy development. Because there are some challenges, and it's quite clear that without innovations, which are really a key point for the future development, without these innovations, we cannot guarantee sustainability of energy system in the future. That we need these innovations. Mm-hmm. And if you go to this model, that what from point of view our students, students should possess what kind of topics, what kind of the knowledge the people could suggest to be described in these topics. What that should be, because this is the title is very attractive and very general. Mm-hmm. But what we should talk about this, about inside of this model, you know, in connection of innovations, role of innovations, maybe type of innovations, technology, what kind of technology could support in which domain, mm-hmm. Observation of these topics, or other things. It's up to the students to decide, okay. Up to our participants.
I understand.
And if they will describe this, they should suggest.
Andrei, sorry for interrupting. May I ask you just,
yes,
I understand. First, we should define should define the learning outcomes, and then based on that, to decide subtopics and main topics.
Yeah, in fact, it could be like this, but in fact, it's also could be done differently, to define main topics and then to mm-hmm. look what kind of the outcomes should be here. But very often, people even working in the both directions simultaneously. They are defining main topics, and then mm-hmm. the learning outcomes, and then they develop subtopics or something like this.
Bottom up.
But because in fact, I'd like that they will play a role of the instructors or teachers.
If you can give us a hypothetical an example, just
The examples were in my presentation. I can switch and show in more details.
Okay. Then please submit your presentation. We will upload to the website. Please have a look.
Can we do? We have to do it now, sir, or we will do later?
No, it's during the
during
when
the workshop.
The time will be allocated.
We have a question. Please come.
Yes, please.
Sir, I have done this, so I will explain this. I am online.
So we will do this exercise. I suggest that we will have three groups here, and also online participants can do it individually also. And you have the email address, and you will have access, and then you can ask Professor Kasilov and also.
It was my question.
Yeah,
thank
please,
you.
Question.
Yes. You answered your former question.
I will send you my presentation, definitely. But again, to give some hints or whatever. If you go to, for example, number, which one? Number two, maybe what? Number six. This is, it's on the screen. This is the expected learning outcomes. We can read now after they received the task. For example, using the model teaching material, describe the framework for modeling and analysis of nuclear energy system scenarios and main elements of the framework. Perform exercises, illustrate familiarity, and so on and so on. This is a very specific outcomes, and the people should demonstrate their knowledge through performing these tasks. For example, perform exercises on nuclear energy system comparative evaluation using the kind ET tool and its extension. But this is specific for Model 6, but I already presented other things, Model 1 and Model 2, they are more general. Then you will find the examples of another expected learning outcome. Summary potential benefits and major risk induced by use of nuclear energy. That probably something like this could be created for innovation technology, because using the also material and ideas which will be presented in another lectures during this week. Because they are also giving you a lot of bread, which you can use for performing this task. At least we will try. Just imagine that you are the teacher. You are the teacher, and you'd like that your people, your students, will understand how innovative technology can help meeting the stability of nuclear energy system. That's it. Just you need to explain them that without innovations, the sustainability of nuclear energy system cannot be obtained. This is your task.
Okay.
Of course, excuse me, Professor Kasilov, I have a question. Yeah. In this your activity, we should indicate the innovations for answering the for answering as a main topics. Okay.
Not only main topics and competences. Of course, when you are, I provide you a title, but inside of the, for example, here, in other, for the model two, I give you overview of the main topics which are inside. They are presented now on the screen. Introduction to sustainable nuclear energy system, nuclear power reactors and fuel cycle, economics, and so on and so on. That's, first of all, I'd like to get this map, this kind of map, from you about the model three.
Okay, I got correctly your information. We need to indicate the innovation in a nuclear energy sector in, for answering the challenges as a main topics.
Yes, answering the challenges and the in order to reach innovation from your point of view.
Okay, okay, I get. And after
to
that, for
stability.
And after indication of the every innovation and or answering, developing for or answering for in a discussion in groups.
Yes, and also I think that when you indication main topics, that you should also think about how these topics will be addressed by students and what they should demonstrate after their learning of this topic.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, better now, better understanding now. So what I suggest we can do, okay, and make another discussion meeting with Professor Kasilov on Wednesday afternoon, and let's say to make a first iteration with presentations. And again, we will split in three groups later. Please start splitting. And online participants will work individually also.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because we don't have.
Of course, questions. I send these presentations right now. Mm-hmm. To Vladimir, and he
will be uploaded to the website, and you can check and try to understand also. This is complicated stuff.
I stop sharing. But at least I think this will give you some field for thinking and combining your
okay, we will try. And please also join us. And finally, so the one iteration and Wednesday afternoon or evening, and finally, the group leaders or group representative, I would say, will make this brief presentation on this on Friday, and Professor Kasil will decide which one is the best. Okay, thank you. Now, good timing. So we now break for the coffee, and we continue at